1997, three Hamas suicide bombers blew themselves up in downtown Jerusalem, killing three and injuring dozens more, including some U.S. citizens. Some of those victims and their families sued Iran for damages in U.S. federal court. And among the assets targeted in the suit were valuable Persian antiquities held by Chicago's Oriental Institute. After making its way across lower courts, the case reached the Supreme Court, which has ruled in a potential precedent-setting judgment. Our culture correspondent, Maya Margit, is here with the story. And what is the story out of the Supreme Court on this case?
So this is quite a complicated tale. It goes back several years. Basically, what happened is that these victims and the families of the victims of the suicide bombing in Jerusalem, which included several U.S. citizens, sued for reparations for compensation for that attack. And they were awarded several years ago $71 million in damages from the Iranian government. They accused the Iranian government of sponsoring those Hamas militants, of supporting them, and basically of being responsible for the attack. So what happened is they were awarded the $71 million, and Iran, of course, ignored that judgment. They said they were not going to pay. They refused to pay. So what the victims tried to do afterwards is find a way of getting back the money after that verdict was reached. And they tried several different ways. They tried to get assets from Iranians living in the U.S., who worked for the government. Every time they tried to request something back, like a house or a property, it was overturned by a court. So then they started to go after cultural artifacts. This is where they moved into the cultural sphere, and they attacked several museums across the U.S. in different states that had Persian artifacts to try to get them back as compensation for the attack. And each time it was overturned, and eventually they reached the Oriental Institute in Chicago, and as well as the Chicago Field Museum of Natural History.
What kind of artifacts are we talking about? What are they trying to get a hold of?
So these are very valuable artifacts, including some of the oldest writing in history. For instance, there's the Persepolis collection. There's 30,000 clay tablets and fragments of clay tablets with ancient writings. They're all loaned from Iran to the Oriental Institute in Chicago, which is interesting, since the 1930s. This is why they went after these specific clay tablets. But the Institute in Chicago basically borrowed them from Iran with the understanding that they would return them, and they fought really hard against the plaintiffs to not return them, because they said, if this happens, then museums around the world can seize U.S. assets and U.S. things, and this could lead to a huge hurdle for the U.S. across
the
world.
So exactly on that potential problem, is there a legal basis for what they're asking for?
So this is a very specific kind of case. Basically, you know, they could have, the justices, the Supreme Court wanted this whole case and this dispute to be resolved diplomatically. They wanted Congress to take a look at this. The Trump administration, U.S. President Donald Trump's administration, and previous the government as well, was always siding with Iran in this case because they felt that the blowout from this, of seizing Iranian artifacts, could lead to many potential problems in the future. There is a federal law called the Foreign Sovereign Immunities Act, which protects, which shields foreign governments from liability in American courts. Doesn't protect Iran, apparently, because Iran does sponsor terrorism.
Right, it's a terror state, and that law does not actually cover terror-supporting states.
Right, but what this case says, because of the ruling, it was a unanimous ruling, by the way, from the Supreme Court against the plaintiffs. Because of this, this shows that in the future, if anyone tries to seize cultural artifacts as payment or compensation from other governments, they might not be able to do it. And this basically sets a precedent, because it's a very unique case. They did have some kind of legal basis and justice in on their side, the victims of the bombing, but to seize cultural artifacts that are very valuable, it's a very kind of, you know, thorny issue.
I think one interesting thing, Maya, is that such a law, even in this case, some may make some people upset, would, for example, protect Israel from, if it would put some of its antiquities abroad, and we know that Israel is targeted, for example, by the Palestinians in various international legal forums, so it, in a way, will cut both ways.
Yeah, that's what this whole case is saying, is that if we start seizing antiquities from this country for this kind of terror attack, then everyone can start seizing each other's antiquities, and museums will be afraid to loan these very valuable artifacts across
the world.
Right,
a dangerous door to open.
Yeah.
All right, Maya Margit, thanks very much for bringing us that story. We